Betrayals on paternity court.
This is the first time that this man has said we're not his kids.
And she said that.
And this man is sitting here after all these years and can look in our face and sit here and say that he's not our father. And you're looking just like us.
And there could,
okay, so
always,
what happens when it comes out that you're not the daddy? You're gonna look stupid as hell.
No, you're gonna look like a f***er. That's what you're gonna look like.
Robert Hicks, convinced he's the daddy, confronted his ex-wife about their child's paternity. Lo and behold, the suspense skyrocketed as the courtroom exploded with the major betrayal reveal. Take a look for yourself.
She said that the baby was mine. I believe that the baby is mine because the baby was made while we were married. And you try to say that the baby isn't ours? I don't believe that, you know?
You need to believe because she's not yours.
No, don't start.
She looks nothing
even
like
start
you. Nothing because... at all. Look at her. She's white. She looks like me. She looks nothing like you.
So in this paternity ride, Hicks confronted his wife, who confesses to cheating and had no shame about her game. The relationship's dynamics, dripping with sarcasm, reveal a roller coaster of cheating, proposals, and disputed paternity.
When she told me that she was pregnant, she said that the baby was yours because when she got pregnant, it was on Valentine's Day. We were having sex consecutively in our two-bedroom apartment. So you're talking about it didn't happen, but yet on Valentine's Day, you're saying that you didn't sleep with me, but yes, you did.
Okay,
you were doing
and there
it
was
all
a six
in the shower
period
all the
after
time.
That.
If you're gonna tell the truth, tell it all the
and
way.
After this, the poor alleged father moment, the defendant claimed he's the father while juggling her other affairs. Huh, this baby mama was trouble. Doubts and hurt emerge as the dearest husband grapples with the lies. Now that is too much to handle, I gotta say.
She never told me she was creeping around. She never said nothing like that.
Tavares, let me ask you
come
something.
On now.
When I look at this picture, I see a couple that looks relatively happy. Were you happy then?
At
were
that
you
time,
pretending?
I was, Your Honor.
You were happy
I
then.
Was at that
so
time.
So there was a time when you met Mr.
When
Hicks.
When I just stopped.
Okay,
then,
so it wasn't a manipulation from the
not
start.
Not the whole thing.
There was a,
there was
a
love
time
at the beginning.
When there was love. Okay.
Oh boy, Mommy was one skilled manipulator. Yep, she knew all the right techniques and had a habit of jumping ships. Plus, the controversial explanation was getting her nowhere, while the baby daddy brought out the pictures to compare features.
I mean, like you said,
that's
the baby
my baby.
Is
why would I lie about her?
Because the baby looked like me when she was a baby.
No, she doesn't.
Look at the nose. Look at the curly
hair. She looks
hair.
Like her dad.
The only thing that's the resemblance is she is light skinned. And there could
okay,
always,
so what happens when it comes out that you're not the daddy? You're gonna look stupid as hell.
No, you're gonna look like a f***er. That's what you're
gonna look like.
According to the defendant, the relationship was not all manipulation, or so she says. Now I know, hard to believe that. However, the drama did not end there. Nuh-uh. Incoming was the sister of the plaintiff, and boy, she hated Mommy with a passion, to say the least. And Miss Navarez wasn't a fan either.
She said that she was going to go visit. She was going to go watch one of her friend's kids or whatever. She left. She came back in about 5-10 minutes talking about, oh, they didn't need me to watch him anymore, but they gave me $100. Then she did it. She was doing it like every day.
She did it like,
oh,
like 5 or 6
yeah,
times.
Every
yeah,
day.
10,
so what are you suggesting that some other
that
man
she was
giving?
Prostituting. That's what I'm suggesting.
Well, baby mama thought everyone was out to get her, which was surprising since she was the perpetrator of this whole mess. Enter Mr. Osorio, then beau of the mommy, and he sang all the praises and joys of fatherhood, which ended up triggering the daddy on the other side. Uh-oh.
You believe you are the father.
I am the father. Because father's the one that spends time, quality time, and be there for them, tell them what's right and what's wrong.
Have you been there?
I've been there. I've been there.
Too much, Your Honor.
I got something to say.
I've been there.
He didn't want nothing to do with her. He said out his own mouth the baby wasn't his. Now all of a sudden he wants to come and say it's his baby. She's 2 years old.
Problems after problems with these guys. I'm telling you, that's what was happening here. And Mr. Hicks didn't like the accusations being piled up on him. But would that stop the mama? Not at all. Boy, she was enjoying this.
One time, she came to my father's house and told me that the baby wasn't mine. I said, we're gonna have to get a DNA test to prove that, because I don't believe you. I don't believe you.
So when it proves that it's not the baby, just leave it at that. We shouldn't be talking about nothing that's irrelevant unless it has to do with baby bud.
If the baby wasn't mine, why did I sign the birth certificate? Why does the baby have my last name?
You can have your last name back.
Not only that,
you can have it back.
The emotions soar as Judge Lake dished out a lesson in accountability. And yep. Then she switched to the envelopes. Guess she had enough of their blame game too. Let's see which way the destiny played out in this case.
In the case of Hicks versus Navarez, and in regards to 2-year-old Yazelin
Hicks, it has been determined by this court, Mr. Hicks, you are not
Thank
her
you.
Father.
You should have just signed your name and you would have looked stupid. Did
he
I not tell you
signed
your right
just now,
over?
Even more right now.
Not so fast though. Oh, this woman was evil, man. But no worries, even if the results played out in her favor, she was due much needed schooling session. And we know who delivers those best around here.
This man ever thought and bonded with this baby.
He's never bonded
was
with her.
He obviously did. When you cut a cord on a child as they are entering this world, you don't know anything about it, but obviously he did or he wouldn't be standing here today. My point is this is all you're doing.
It was a Palmer versus Palmer paternity show down here because identical twins were ready to confront a potential father, kicking off a wild roller coaster of denials and surprises. This is gonna be interesting.
Miss Palmer, you are appearing today in court with your identical twin sister, petitioning the court for a paternity test to prove the defendant is your biological father. Mr. Palmer, you argue that it is impossible for you to be the biological father of the Palmer twins.
Yes, Your Honor.
Let's dig into this messy saga, because Mr. Palmer not only denied paternity of the twins, but also claimed to have never seen them. Oh yeah, and in doing so, he went down memory lane and narrated his version of the events.
When I met their mother, she worked at a job. I was married.
We've always seen her.
And me and my wife were separated.
Okay.
Okay, so my sister's a little troublemaker.
Okay.
So she introduced me to their mother. When I met them, before I met their mother, here's number one. She's already pregnant.
My mother was a virgin.
You better watch out.
My mother was a virgin when
okay?
she met him.
Oh, the defendant was not done with his story yet. He was given out the performance of a lifetime with all the right theatrics. The twins, however, were not buying any of it. But then the conception calendar came up, and boy, was that confusing as heck.
What you're saying is you met their mother in March.
You see those babies and you didn't want to be a part of their life?
Of 1981.
Uh-huh.
And Maisha and Aisha were born September 14th. Count back 6 months.
Six months.
And therefore, you say it's impossible that you are their father.
It's impossible.
So, the potential father's reaction to pregnancy was disbelief. But the Palmer twins' reaction to his version of past events was more than that. Oh, they were beyond mad with the way the supposed father had been acting. Cue the eruption of court in total chaos.
This is the first time that this man has said we're not his kids.
And she said
and
that.
And this man is sitting
and
here
after all these years
and can look in our face and sit here and say that he's not our father. And you're looking just like us. After all that,
believe me,
should have inquired about your kids and made sure that the other two, besides the 10, was taken care of too.
See, that comes back
to... they know you too.
That comes back to this year.
Well, these guys had one thing in common. They were loud as heck. Moving on, details emerge about the mother's relationship with the potential father and his family. The defendant still stuck to his story, though, adding fuel to the already raging fire.
Okay, please. This is from my Auntie Desiree. She says they started dating in 1979. When she found out he was married, he disappeared. The twins were born and he was not around. We found out he had a whole family because we got a hold of his address and drove by his house one time. We saw him with his wife and his two kids. My sister looked through the window and saw him with his family and was hurt and left.
Yeah, this Palmer dude was one cold fella. He showed no emotions while the twins shared the fatherless life they had lived all their lives. However, he brought his biological daughter along with him to back him up. Let's see what she's got to say.
I know my dad has been honest. I understand their anger, but I know my dad. He's always been very honest. He has 10 kids. He's never denied any of his kids. If he had any doubt in his mind, I'm sure he would have stepped up to the plate. I'm sure he would have asked for DNA. He just did it with his 4-year-old.
So and when I reached out to
we heard
here,
about it. We heard,
receptive.
But my mom right. told me as a kid that these were not my sisters.
Well, there was one more surprise witness. Yep, another kid amongst the 10 kids of Mr. Palmer also stepped up, but he had a different story to share. Man, the potential baby daddy was one sneaky fella.
I've always known about the girls, you know, I've always heard through family members about the girls, but I've never been able to see them or confirm with them that, you know, they're my blood. I mean, I've never laid eyes on them either. This is my first time seeing them. I actually, since we share the same last name, I claimed them as my sisters. I always say we have, what about the twins? Or things like that.
Wow.
It was time to drop the bombshell. Yep, the court was ready to announce the paternity test results. This decades-old mystery was about to come to an end. Let's see what shockwaves go through the room this time.
Mr. Palmer, you are their father.
Sorry, I'm sorry.
Whoa. Can you explain to the court what's going through your head right now?
I was told that she's pregnant. And then to come back and tell me that she's pregnant by me, don't never do that to a man.
Mr. Jordan here accused Ms. Heim of trapping him in daddy duty while pointing fingers at another potential father. Cue the DNA showdown, as he had a whole monologue prepared as to how the mommy tricked him. Get ready, people.
I think her only motive was that she was able to get away with it. Because at the end of the day, I think that she had the advantage as far as to having a dad that could take care and provide for Caitlin. You know what I'm saying? So
you thought her motive really was that you were a provider, you were there for the child, and you were going to do right by the child.
Right.
While Daddy spun the tale of deceit, Mommy was not on board for any of those accusations. Oh, she defended herself, blaming a miraculous conception and loyalty to Mr. Jordan. Cue the drama-infused accusations.
Well, I know that Chris is the father.
But how, if he had sex with the other guy?
Well, he listens to his family members, my family members, the people on the street, and everything about that. And I just came today to show everybody on the street, his family members, my family members, that he's the father, and I'm tired of it.
Because it is upsetting you.
Yes.
So, Mommy felt hurt and betrayed. However, the plaintiff claimed it was all hunky-dory till he got into an altercation with a few family members of hers. And so, the paternity drama began and was still ongoing.
This is where it goes wrong. Her and the family member gets into like an altercation or whatnot, like an argument. It wasn't even an altercation, an argument. And it was like, they started like throwing dirt on each other, you know what I mean? She said something about this family member's in front of this family member's boyfriend or whatever. So the family member turned around and was like, well, why you ain't told Chris that? He's not Caitlin's dad.
What?
Well, that must have been shocking to hear from the plaintiff's perspective. And the pictures were just the icing on the paternity cake here. Well, the alarm bells were rung now, and all Mommy could do was just smile through everything. What's that about, huh?
So this is another one posted up, and it reads, me and my baby Kate.
And my thing is, when did anybody get the time to even take my daughter over to somebody else's house? Like, how am I the last person to find out?
Do you know who this man is, Ms. Heim?
That's the guy I had sex one time with when I met Chris.
Oh, Mommy was due for an explanation, and it better be a credible one. Alas, that was not the case with this mommy. She thought she could run circles around the judge with her story. Well, she was sorely mistaken for that one.
How did she get over there? Did you take her over there?
That time I did on that couch.
That time? So it's been more than one time?
No, that was the only one
time. Your Honor, I object.
What was your point?
I mean, I didn't tell him that I told him I was pregnant.
Ms. Heim, I'm going to need you to tell me what the deal is.
Oh, this woman fooled us with her tears at the start. But she was one cunning woman. She was playing a dangerous game, though, playing both guys like a fiddle. And Mr. Knight just came in and opened Pandora's box of her manipulations.
She told me to do with my baby. She said, I'm pregnant. I said, what you telling me for? She said, cause it's yours. Telling me I love you when you get home. I let somebody else sign a birth certificate. I'm gonna fix it when you get home. Did it in third. I'm like, okay, say no more.
No.
Miss High, what kind of game you running?
I ain't running no game.
Good game. Fact. Sheila.
You would think after this mess, the woman would have learned her lesson, but nope. Oh, she was still playing, and with both of them. She just stood there smirking around and watching the chaos without a care in the world. Ugh, the nerve.
You burst out crying when the case first started. You just so tired of this, and you just want it to be over. What's behind your eyes? What are you feeling? You just fine. I wasn't gonna let you stand up here and have a smirk on your face like this was a game.
About time we draw the curtain on this chain of betrayals. The verdict was ready to be delivered, and emotions soar as the judge reveals the contents of the sealed envelope. Here we go.
It has been determined by this court. The biological father is Mr. Jordan. Ms. Heim? These two young men have loved your child, have treated her like She was theirs, developed bonds, but at some point we had to get to the truth.